Well, that's not bad. Not sure whether I mentioned it or not, but my lovely wife bought me a beer fridge for Christmas. And I've been trying to get the thermostat on it set properly, and this is what I've thrown together to do that. It's just a nano and a DHT temperature sensor and a little, was it 16 by 2 LCD. But that's a little janky, and I want to just make sure that it's actually cycling properly and monitor this a little bit more long term, a bit less real time than this. So let's build something. So things that we're going to need, let's try a little Arduino Pro Mini. And we need a temperature sensor, some DHT11s. What else we got in here? Ah, there's another one of the same little DHT12s that I'm already using. Let's use that. And to keep track of the temperature, let's grab that SD card reader that we got a few weeks ago. Nonsuch Brewing's Baltic Porter. A very nice little beer. And 6.5% boozles. But the first step in every good project is to breadboard it up. And I've got a bit of a head start on this, because you don't need to spend time watching me plugging stuff in. I'll show you what I got going on down here, though. The SD card reader here uses SPI, so it's got chip select, serial clock, Mozzie Meso, power, and ground. So that is connected to where you would expect it to be, pins 11, 12, and 11, 12, 13, and chip selects on pin 4, just because that's where the sketch that I decided to pull has it. Meanwhile, this DHT12 sensor uses I2C. So it is connected to SCL and SDA over here, and then power and ground. And that's really all there is to the wiring. This being a Pro Mini, it doesn't have its own USB interface, so I'm just temporarily connecting it to this one. And this isn't the one that I'm going to ultimately put into my project and solder up. I'm going to use one that doesn't have pins on it already on it. This is just my breadboard one. And the code that I've thrown together is basically just two different sketches, demo sketches glued together. The DHT12 sketch, which is not in the standard libraries. I had to go and find one on this GitHub page here, the DHT12 sensor library. Which also gives some good information about the sensor, showing the pinout and a bunch of stuff like that. And a lot of the sample code just came from further up in here too, so that's not that hard to deal with. So that is that piece of code there, and it can print out a whole bunch of different things. I'm just choosing to use the basic Celsius, because that is the default. The second place that I borrowed my code from is just the demo from this SD card library here. This is just the data logger sketch. And I hooked up the SD card module just like it's shown there, Mozzie Meso clock and chip select. And then the demo sketch has it reading from three different analog pins and just dumping them into a file with the values separated by a comma, which makes it really easy to read this back into a spreadsheet or something, because you just do comma separated values and boom, there it is. That's that. So I basically just took those two and glued them together into my own and cleaned it up a little bit. So there's the library includes, setups and stuff. I cleaned things up a little bit, initializing the SD card, initializing the sensor. And then it reads the temperature sensor, just the Celsius. I don't care about anything else for this. It builds the data string, and I'm timestamping it. Just for the demonstration right now, I'm just having it timestamp it every 5 seconds. And then puts comma in a space and the value from up here. It does the magic to write the string and prints it out, and then we'll wait 5 seconds. For the real one, I'm probably going to wait like 10 minutes or something, or 5 minutes, or something like that. But just for this, we'll do it like this. And uploading. It's using almost half of the board, but there we go. So we'll pop the serial port open, and every 5 seconds it should add another value. And that doesn't look all that exciting, does it? Oh, it's changed a little bit. I'm going to blow my heat gun at the temperature sensor for a little bit, and it should jump in a couple of readings here. Come on, jump. There we go. So one thing about these DHT type temperature sensors, you don't want to read them that frequently. They have a bit of a wait time and a bit of a settle down time. So you see it has a little bit of inertia there. It took a while for that to come up to temperature. Anyways, let's go back to the breadboard. I think you'll agree that that's a pretty straightforward little thing. And now it's been running for a while. I'm just going to unplug it and see what we got on the file, just to make sure that the file's writing properly. Using one of these cheesy little SD card readers that I got a whole bunch of at an auction a while back. Okay, so there's our data log file. And here we go, the timestamps and the temperatures. And there you can see where we put the heat gun to it, and it's starting to come back down. So what I should be able to do with that, I should be able to read that into a spreadsheet. There we go. And if I do this and do this and do this, I should be able to get a chart out of it. If I was a little bit better at spreadsheets and charts and things, I could probably make that a little bit prettier. But for now, I can see what's been going on in my fridge. Right, let's commit this to a proper circuit board and permanentize it. I think I'll use my new iron. Thank you once again for desoldering these, because it's got a nice big tip. And when you're removing header pins, just remember that they are incredibly inexpensive and consumable. As much as it's hard for me to overcome my cheapness, sometimes I just have to remind myself of that. So I've just got the pins that I need on the bottom of this guy. I haven't done all of them because I don't want to confuse myself when I'm on the bottom side. I want to make sure that I get onto exactly the pins that I intend. And for working on soldering these smaller pins down, I'm using my older iron because it just happens to have some smaller tips with it. I got some smaller tips on order for that new T12 iron, but as with everything ordered from China, it's not here yet. Now I just have to fit it onto this piece of perf board. And I don't think I have to be all that economical with space, but I do want to leave room to be able to get the SD card in and out. So maybe I will go this way. Drop this guy in somewhere close to it. It doesn't really matter that much. Sure, that'll work. Suppose I should give it a power connector too. Yeah, I know it's far from a modern power connector, but whatever. I have plenty of them. And now all that's left to do is wire everything up. Just got that guy flipped over just for reference. I'll just go through and wire everything up here. last one is my last pin, which is chip select. It was way over here to pin 4. Okay, that's the board. Looks not too bad. The only thing left now is to wire the sensor on. And for the sensor, I'm going to use some of this four-wire, what is it sold as? Servo cable. I think maybe I'll put down about that much. I mean, I2C isn't a super long distance protocol, but I think this will do the job. So that is one of the two data lines. That's the ground or negative power. Now the red wire is going to be the other data wire. This one, the blue wire, is gonna be the positive voltage. Little heat shrinklies on there. Give them a quick shrink down. There, that's pretty nice. Should I come in up here? Maybe, huh? Sure, that makes sense. Okay, so in that case, my two data lines will go off that way, my two power lines will go off that way. So blue is positive power, and what did I say? Green was negative power. Is that green? I don't know. Those all still connected, yeah. Okay, just my two data wires left to go. See, I don't even have to think about what the number is because I'm just going off the position. And then black, which is 2 over from it. No, black is the one on the far right hand side, which is that one there, which goes to that guy. I should already know that. You on there? Sure. So that should be it done, at least from an electrical point of view. Still have to make a hole in the box for the power connector and find a screw to fit in there. This gets ugly. Okay, that fits, and that doesn't quite fit. I have a little bit more carving to do. Damn it. Okay, there, it all fits. Now then, the last thing to do, something I probably should have done earlier, but whatever, is to get the programming on there. Ground, VCC, the two datas, and then the DTR, which resets the board. This is awful tricky, plugging these things in, especially with it in there. That was an oversight. Okay, so that's all in there. Let's put a bit of pressure on that and upload the sketch to it. Power's up, that's a good sign. Compiling, uploading, done uploading. So I can disconnect that now. Put my SD card in there and hook up my little 5-volt BlackBerry power supply to it. After rethinking my code a little bit and consulting with my resident code monkey, I made a couple of changes. The first change was in here. Instead of doing the math on millis and dropping it into there to create a counter number, I just made a counter. Where we initiate it up here, add it to the string down here, and with the semicolon and the, or with the comma, sorry, and the temperature sensor, and then increment it down here at the bottom of the loop. That's fairly straightforward. The other thing that I did is changed the time, so now it's recording every 60,000 milliseconds, so once every 10 minutes or thereabouts, because I don't need every minute to minute. It's a beer fridge. So now all that's left to do is install it, which is pretty easy. Let's pull that guy out of the way. I think I'm going to put it. I think I'm going to just sort of tie it on. Well, I don't know where I'm going to put it in here yet. Maybe just sort of loose in there. What's that do? Yeah, that's not touching anything. Okay. So just kind of loose in there. And then there's power plug back in there. I'm going to save the effort of watching me struggle to get back in there. But then it's done. And I can check on how well this fridge is actually maintaining a relatively stable temperature. And I can return this stuff to the parts bin. Well, that was kind of fun. Sort of a practical project. I mean, did I really need to make one of these? No, but yeah, that's never stopped anybody before. This was sort of doing the job. But it will be good to see, just to verify if that cheap little fridge is maintaining a relatively stable temperature, or is it going all over the place? Is it ducking down below freezing? Yeah, that's actually an important one for storing the beer. You don't want it to freeze on you. That would be horrible. A tragedy indeed. Yeah, that was fun. If any comments or questions, as usual, down in the, you know, in, down there. Yeah. Thanks for watching. I will talk to you again.